Okay, this is I think Gus Cannon originally, but it's been done by Lead Belly and Big Bill Brunzi.
Okay, let's quiet everyone.
Okay,
that's Rick.
Oh yeah, lead all. I didn't see Mr. Birdman appear there. He actually should have gone before you. So just this once, we'll have him next, and then we'll get him in sync next time. So I'm going to mute everybody, and you got to unmute yourself.
Oh, it's for me?
Yes.
Oh, okay, okay. That's no problem. Hey, I know I'm going to get a chance to read. I don't care who go first or last or, you know.
Stuart and I do.
So. Okay. This is a poem from one of my poetry books. It's called A View in the Moonlight. Open the window for the moonlight. The mummy's behind me, stumbling along the way. The sheets are all twisted on the bed. The knots are untying from the sweat. Loosen them, cut them, and open the sashes. The moon in the window shining bright. The night is now passing. Blackness, the blackness. I must let it in. The cat and the wasp and the night and the wind. I'm in emotional trouble. Is this a waking dream? Do I need freedom in my life? I feel like I'm underwater. Open the window. Let the sun shine in. Thank you.
Go on.
That would have been a good one for our Halloween edition.
Who wrote that? Was that your poetry book or somebody else's poetry book?
No, this is my poetry. It's from the poem that I wrote.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
Yeah. I did do a Halloween poem. It's called The Hunt Is On, but I did it on some other open mics during that weekend. So, yeah, but thank you.
I used a lot of material from our Halloween edition and the Friends Meeting Halloween Party video, which was fun.
Huh. Okay. Next comes up Mr. Chip. I'll mute everybody.
All right. Seeing how this is kind of stone soup, well, it's not really Celtic, so I got prepared for doing Celtic. So anyway, that's the way it's going to be. Either way. So the first one isn't really a Celtic tune. So all that discussion, it isn't really a Celtic tune. The first one I'll do is one of my own, actually. And I think the lesson, you know, a lot of the tunes, I don't know, I've written probably 36 different mandolin tunes over the year, something like that, maybe more, maybe fewer, and they vary from being kind of bluegrassy to old time Appalachian to this one's kind of Celtic sounding. And I think the lesson out of this one is you know, I like to let friends or family members help me with names to them if I haven't really figured it out. And this one, I made the mistake of asking my wife if she'd like to name it. So the name of this tune is called The Smart Wife. Anyway, she honest to goodness named it, and that's the name of the tune. But anyway, here we go. Four times through. It's in whatever 2/4 time. It's in the key of kind of E minor G. So here we go. 95 beats per minute. Thank you.
nice, very nice.
Good accompaniment there too.
Thank you, Strum Machine. Appreciates that.
And so no, an E minor gave me a chance to try out my new gadget. I've got a new fifth string capo.
All right. And
searching for the best fifth string capo, and I still don't know if I found it, but
you know, that would make guitarists go crazy.
That would what?
That would make guitarists go crazy to have a fifth string capo. I don't know what it would do to a guitar to only capo the fifth string. It would change.
Well, you don't only capo the fifth string.
No, I'm saying if you had one, that would change your the shape of your chords.
Yeah, between all the tuning and having two capos, it makes a banjo performance lengthy.
Right.
Very little of it is banjo playing, though.
Yes, I have a very close friend named Dr. Larry Marshall, who is a retired astrophysicist professor from Gettysburg College in Pennsylvania, and he's a crackerjack banjo player, and I always tell him that he's living proof that it does take a rocket scientist to play the banjo.
Oh, goodness. Okay, well, thanks for that. The next one is... The Harton herd. Let me mute everybody. Maybe. There we go. Bonk.
There we go. Now we're unmuted. When Terry played his song about Josie, one of our dogs is named Josie. So she was listening to that song and she wanted to get in Daddy's lap. And so she did while you were playing that song. Since this is Stone Soup, I gave Jeff first choice of first song we do. And he chose one of our old favorites, Sicilian by J.S. Bach, which we played a lot of times. It's a good piece for weddings and churches and just some good old Baroque music. So we're going to do it on a soprano recorder and guitar.
Go for Baroque.
Washed out. Hold on. I'm going to take that off. Let me get our background off of there real quick. Oh, darn it. We're having trouble getting the back with the backgrounds. Okay, hold on. Okay, here we go. Now we're ready. Thank you.
Exquisite. Wow.
And I didn't even have to rearrange my capos.
That was really good.
Thanks.
I didn't have to rearrange my vocal capo either.
It took me back a few hundred years, that one did.
Yeah, every once in a while I have to use those music degrees.
My early childhood.
That one certainly got you to the fifth degree.
Do you have the music degrees, you two?
Yeah, we both do.
Yeah, why am I not surprised?
It shows occasionally.
I have a degree of music myself, but there we go.
I have no degrees. I have a junior high trombone level. So, Stuart, it's up with you. Let me mute everybody. Find the mouse here. Mute all. Yes.
All right. Says one I picked up about 4 years ago. I was hiking in South Wales on the Pembrokeshire coast. Lovely, rugged granite coastline. And there's a fishing port there called Fishguard, very old place. It was on a Neolithic trail dating back 4,000 years or more. Last place to stop before you went over to Ireland. Anyway, they had a pub there where there's a folk society met every couple of weeks, and just happened to be, we were nearby when they were meeting. So I sat in on a session, and some long-haired, old, bearded, a bit like some of the people in this group. Anyway, he started playing this song on a mandolin at the end, and it was a great song. And I looked it up, and it's popularized by Andy Irvine of Planxty fame. He didn't write it, but it's about a guy who came over to, true story, came over to the States in the early 1900s, lived here all his life, raised a family, and having escaped poverty, decided in his 60s or 70s to go back to his poor village. And the song explains why. It's called Indiana. Fare thee well now, Indiana. Your green land has been good to me. There I travel. There I settled, there I raised up my family. But the cord has never severed, and the longing each day it has grown. So tomorrow I'll be leaving for the land that I call my home. All my friends say that I'm crazy going back to such poverty. America is, so they say now, the land of opportunity. But the shy hare runs so swiftly, and the heron slowly flies. These are treasures for my homeland that all your money can never buy. And as a ship lies in the harbor, I shall look back on your shore, and I feel sadness that I'm leaving your green land forevermore. But as a ship lies on the ocean, and each day we are out on the sea, all the dreams I've had for years now drawing nearer reality.
pretty well now. Indiana, your green land has been good to me. There I traveled, there I settled, there I raised up my family. But the cord has never severed, and the longing each day it has grown. So tomorrow I'll be leaving for the land that I call my home.
Yay!
Huzzah, huzzah. Hello, David. Nice. How are you?
Very nice. I identify with that song just a little bit.
Just a little. Okay. Well, let's see, David, before I go on to Tom, is your wife with you today?
Yes,
she is.
Is she going to grace us with some music later?
Well, Rick, I've injured my thumb and I can't play my instruments.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, well, I guess you're forgiven in the case of inability to play.
Yeah, I'm really sad. Working on a really fun tune.
Well, maybe it'll get better soon. Okay, it's over to Mr. Tom, and I will mute everybody.
You don't have to. They can play. I just would like them to play according to this the score chart here. Okay, can everyone hear?
Of course I can't.
You can. Our spiritual big brother, Alice Faye Blackwell Mickens, Amelia Yvette Bourgeois, Amy Schlucago, Amy Warmer, Andrew Jason Banks, Andrew L. Burton Jr., Andrew Lopez, Anthony Rodriguez, Antonio Torres Torres, Anya Wynn, Amanda Lego Rodriguez, Aaron Moore, Arturo Maldonado Macavillis, Arturo Labra Resendiz, Aluria Alaman, Baby Gasore, Baby Pinson, Barbara Jean Bennett Stewart, Barry Lynn Blevins, Benjamin Blackie, Bennett Rawls, Bessie Olivia Hayes, DJ Kuma Sinha, Bike Mike Twice, Bonnie Tenwan, Brenda Lewis Event, Brian Lee Hoff, Bridget Lee, Bruce Edward Jefferson, Calvin Jack McLaren, Carl Evans Franklin, Carlos Valera Serrano, Carol Miller, Carol Mai Shockley, Casoy Lebona, Charles Eddie Cleveland, Charles Edward Holt, Charles George Howard, Charles Manuel, Charles Wayne Packrath, Cherry Joy Pittman Droddy, Christian Trapp, Christina Michelle Garza, Christopher Shane Little, Christopher Paul Marquino, Cindy Lavelle Dougal, Claude Jensens Jr., Craig Michael Sloan, Crispin Guerrera Benitez, Daniel Mahida, Daniel Luis Tracetti, Darius D., David Wayne Aldridge, David Garcia Torva, David Allen Hunter, David Earl Johnson, David Eric Neal, David Perez, David Robertson, David Stark, David James Winkleret, David Sasquatch Colbert. These are some of the 264 people who died on the streets of Austin this year. So I could read more if you have time, but I didn't want to steal your time. But their names need to be remembered because no one else will ever hear these words. They certainly can't say them themselves. So is there any time to read more, or is it over to song?
I guess it's over to song. You can read more next time around, I guess.
Oh, well.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's see. Next coming up is Mary Jane. Let me mute everybody here and you can have at it.
Is that it?
I don't see you've unmuted yourself. Mary Jane.
I'm having some trouble with the finger and the button.
Ah, okay.
I tried several times and it wouldn't unmute.
Okay, go ahead.
I didn't have the right touch. But I think I'm unmuted now as you are listening to me. And the song I've got for to lead off with today is "So Whoopie Tie I-O, Get Along Little Doggies." And I really didn't have any background on it, so I just looked it up in Rise Up Singing, and they said it was collected and adapted by John Lomax, so it would certainly be classified as a traditional song. And they also said they thought it had its origins in Ireland and had been rewritten by cowboys to express their own experiences out on the trail. So with that knowledge, and I don't do all the verses. Rise Up Singing has about twice as many verses, but these are the ones I learned originally. And I just didn't have the energy to learn the rest of them. But yeah, they really have a lot of verses. If you're interested in finding more, check out Rise Up Singing. As I was out walking one morning for pleasure, I spied a cowpuncher a-riding along. His hat was thrown back and his spurs were a-jingling. And as he approached, he was singing this song. Whoopie-tie-yi-yo, get along, little doggies. It's your misfortune and none of my own. Whoopie-tie-yi-yo, get along, little doggies. You know that wild meat will be your new home.
Huzzah, huzzah.
Hey,
Yeah, my Texan wife had to school me on how to pronounce doggy because I was thinking about rounding up dogs, evidently.
Yeah, so. Doggies is not acceptable.
Different critter.
The Irish
chew as a greenhorn.
The Irish song that is taken from is called "The Old Man Rocking the Cradle," and it's got nothing to do with cattle whatsoever.
Yeah, well, that was the Irish song that was referenced in Rise Up Singing. I've never heard that one, I don't think.
You should check it out on YouTube. It's a really great song, but it, as you might imagine, it's more about domestic relationships than it is about cowboying.
Right.
Well, yes. It didn't sound like it had much to do with cow punching.
Okay, I guess we're kind of down.
To start wearing a Dale Evans outfit to cowboy songs.
Well, I have a black and white cowboy hat.
Yeah,
I usually save it for like Halloween or something.
See, she had a kerchief too, didn't she?
Oh yeah. I've got everything needed. I've got boots and everything, but.
Yeah. If David isn't here, you could finish this off with happy trails sometime.
Yeah, I'm not much of a cow puncher myself, but I like cowboy songs.
Yeah, I hear
I have a collection of them.
Yeah, do you have spurs that jingle, jangle, jingle?
I hear tell that cows don't like being punched too much.
Yeah.
I take it on good authority. Okay, I guess we're down to me. So here goes me. I'm going to mute everybody. Okay. I guess I'll set this one up. This is called Poem for Kathy. And the background on this was I'm a member of a St. John's United Methodist Church elder choir. And this lady's mother, she brought her mother to choir practice every week. And anytime we had a performance, she carried her mother there. And she sat out in the outer area of the church on a pew. And I thought, well, that's not good. She's almost old enough to join this group. And so one day I went over to her and we talked for a while. And I mentioned poetry and she said, oh, can you write a poem? And I said, well, sure, I'll write a poem and I'll bring it to you next week. And so this is the poem. Poem for Kathy. Exiting the door was all I knew until I saw you there in the pew. I approached you there and talked a bit to find out if you care. Exposure to poetry is not for all, because there's in their own estimation. They can't be told to think about words. They think are tools that are all cold. In the hands and feelings and mind of the writer, not smart, just kind, they paint the skies of planets old, along with telling the stories not found in paper. Who knows the feeling you had when last the wind blew your hair? And you were glad. Who saw when the lightning rent the air and you were unable to shut the window, so you lay there frozen by your scare? The answer is no one, no one at all. But the poet finds something to call attention to in this time of hustle, bustle, and phone. And those words you hear while reading this are those of common links to tell you you're not alone.
Good one.
Yes.
She seemed to like it. So, let's see. I guess it's now that we've exhausted the group, we'll go back to the guy who was supposed to be first, Mr. David. So, it's up to you, senor. I will mute everybody with a one and a two and a... There you go.
Hello, everybody. So I'm not very much for topical songs. Tropical songs, maybe, but topical songs, not so much. Except I also believe that whatever is old is new again. And sometimes an old song will have relevance for today. So this might help your spirits. It's basically a song about defying and overcoming evil and getting drunk. And of course, it's a cowboy song also. So it's called The Syrie Peaks. Where the yellowjack pines grow tall, Buster Gigs and Sagebrush Sam at a roundup late last fall. Any old cow that flop long ears and then pull out by day, had his long ears chiseled and his old eye chiseled in a most artistic way. Sagebrush Sam to Buster Gigs as he threw his long legs down. I'm getting tired of cowpography and I reckon I'll jog to town. We started out at a right smart lope, for it weren't one side of a ride. Them was the days when an old cowpunch could aisle up his inside. At the old Kentucky bar, they stopped near the head of the whiskey row, and they wound up tight sometime that night, about 40 drinks below. Then the house turned round, sat them up, started them the other way. Honest to goodness, tell the truth, them boys got skewed that day. They both lit out for the Syrie Peaks, packing up a darn good load. And who should they meet but the devil himself come prancing down the road. Confound you ornery cowboy skunks, you better had to hunt your holes, for I am the devil from Hell's Rim Rocks, come to gather in your souls. Be damned, said Buster Gigs, we boys both know we're tight. But before you corral any cowboy souls, you'll sure have a hell of a fight. He threw his rope and he threw her well, she spun down good and true. And he looped the devil by his pointed horns and he took his dallies too. Now Sagebrush Sam was a lariat man with his gut line coiled up neat. He threw her out fair and he built him a hole and he looped the devil's hind feet. They laid him down and stretched him out while the sizzling iron grew hot. Trimmed his horns with a dehorning saw and they branded him a lot. Tied 10 knots in the old boy's tail and left him there for a joke, with a beller and a cough as they loped right off, tied up to a blackjack oak. So if you ever go riding in the Syrie Peaks and you hear a hell of a wail, you'll know it's the devil as he yells and growls about the knots tied in his tail.
A lively one. Yay.
That was great. Loved
applause, it. Applause.
That's a lot of technical terms in that, like cowboyography.
Yeah. Cowboyography.
Terry, dallies are.
Dallies is from the Spanish, where if you're tying your rope around the saddle horn, you run around like that. And so if you were speaking Spanish, you would say, dale la vuelta. And so that became Dally's.
A lot of cowboy terms are from Spanish, aren't they?
Indeed. The arrieta.
Vaquero and riata was lasso and rodeo and barbecue and lots of stuff.
Maybe, how about chaps?
Probably so.
Yeah. Something like that, yeah.
I think it was direct from Chaparral, but most cowboys call those leggings anyway.
I don't know about that. Anyway, Mr. Flying in the Air Birdman is next. So I'll mute everybody one moment here. Now they're muted. Let's see. I think you forgot to unmute yourself.
Okay, there you go. I'm gonna read this poem. It's based on what I wrote when I was at the beach, which I'll be going there this weekend just to chill and relax. And it's titled Blue Waves. Blue waves wash in on a warm summer day. The ocean with blue and white waves roll in, bringing joy and peace. The sky is blue with no clouds in sight. The mountains in the background are covered in fog. Listen to the blue waves splash and roll in from the depths of the ocean. It is breathtaking watching the waves. A scene is so beautiful. Freedom and peace run through the mind and bring a chill to the spine. Footprints can no longer be seen in the sand on the shoreline. Sandcastles can no longer withstand the waves and are washed away until nothing remains. The tides continue to splash. It is a very relaxing moment. A cool breeze refreshes as tension is released. Thank you.
Very good.
Good one.
I take it that came from a vacation.
No, we live close down here in Houston. We live close to some water, 30 minutes. So every other front, well, no, actually every week we go to one of the beaches, either one in Clear Lake or the one in LaPorte. So it's been, yes, I love it down there. And that's my relaxation.
Very good. Okay. Well, super. Mr. Terry, I believe, next falls upon thee.
Okay, all right. Here we go. You know, I have a songwriting challenge for someone who wishes to take it up, and that's that, you know, after Election Day, when the news was not so good in other places, the news was really quite good where I live. We re-elected our city council, a very progressive city council member, Greg Kassar, and I'm in Lloyd Doggett's district, and both of those guys got 70% of their vote, and of course we went overwhelmingly for Trump, and I thought, well, I'm just living in my blue heaven. And it seems like it should be a song. Maybe someone can work that out. So,
I think someone already wrote that song about my blue heaven.
Okay, let's see. So this is a song by one of my favorite all-time banjo players, Uncle Dave Macon. And it's a song about the new Jim Crow, or the pre-Jim Crow, new Jim Crow, in which African-American convict labor was used to not only get a lot of free labor, but also to break the unions. And this is about a coal mine in Tennessee where they worked the mines with prison labor, mostly African-American. And it's kind of from the point of view of the labor union. Thank you. Tennessee, they lease convicts out. They work in many coal mines against free labor. Some free labor rebellious, to win it took some time. But while they swept in effect, they made them rise and join. But he drove down the line, but he drove down the line. Yamagamagamagam, coming down the line. But he drove down the line, but he drove down the line. Yamagamagamagam, coming down the line. Well, early Monday morning, they got him out on time, marching down the lone rock. Look into that mine, they march you down the lone rock. Look into that hole. The very last words the captain said, we better get your coal. Buddy, don't you roll down the line. Buddy, won't you roll down the line. Young gun, my darling, come down the line. Buddy, won't you roll down the line. Won't you roll down the line. Young gun, my darling, come down the line. The beans, they are all tapping. The meat is not so well. The bread is all burnt up and the coffee's packed. It's hallelujah. Or heck. Uncle Dave never said curse words. It was always heck or hallelujah. The coffee's black as heck, but when you get your task done, you better come to call. Or anything you get to eat tastes good than our own. Buddy, what you rolling down the line? Buddy, what you rolling down the line? Gonna come and die, then come down the line. Buddy, what you rolling down the line? Buddy, what you rolling down the line? Gonna come, my darling, coming down the line. He's a hard man, a man you all know well. And if you don't get your task done, he's gonna give you a hallelujah. They'll carry you to the stockade, and it's on the floor you'll fall. The very next time they come on, call on you, you know you'll get your goal. But don't you roll down the line, but don't you roll down the line. Gonna come, my darling, coming down the line. Buddy, won't you roll down the line? Buddy, won't you roll down the line? Gonna come, my darling, coming down the line.
Good one, good one, good one.
Hey! You know,
very good stuff.
That was on the anthology.
It was on the anthology?
Yeah. The Harry Smith Anthology of American Folk Music Recordings.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Gosh, you must be an expert at this stuff.
Well, everybody has the Harry Smith Anthology memorized.
Not really. It was not a requirement at the engineering school at UT.
More's the pity.
Hey, Rick.
Okay. Yeah.
We have a new member has joined us.
Oh, yeah? Ah, there you go. Matthew, let's see. Are you going to be singing or poetrying? You gotta unmute yourself.
No,
I still don't hear you. Matthew, we can't hear you.
He's unmuted, but he's still voiceless.
Yeah.
Your microphone off or something like that?
Check your microphone.
The sound may be turned way down.
Yeah, turn your sound up. Use original sound.
Oh, wow. That's right.
While you're doing that, welcome. There's no pressure. Just so you know that, sir.
Yeah, right. We'll like you no matter how long it takes to hear you. while you get that figured out, we're going to move on to Chip here. I think I will mute everybody now, and we will see how things go. Mute all, yes.
All right. Well, Matthew, welcome, and we'll hear you in just a minute or two while you figure it out. I've probably done these three tunes, maybe even this set before, but somehow or another, I thought today was the Celtic session. I got it mixed up with the Stone Soup session, so I kind of thought I would do a couple Celtic tunes. But this is a Irish set, so three different tunes. The first tune is actually a West Virginia tune called Rachel, but if you're in Texas, it's sometimes called the Texas Quick Step if you live in Texas. And then the second tune is in the key of G, and it's called Spudiscary. It's actually a Scottish tune. And I looked up once, David may know better, but Spudiscary in Scottish is like one of those cairns of rocks that you might see on a riverbank that people stack up. That's theoretically what a Spudiscary is. And then the third one is an honest to goodness Irish tune called Silver Spear, so, and it's back in the key of D. So we'll go from the key of D to the key of G and back to the key of D in the set, and I will be using my amazing backup program Strum Machine will be participating in this. So here we go. 95 beats per minute. Thank you.
Excellent. Excellent.
Thank you very much.
Very, very fleet fingered.
Thank you.
Fleet of finger and foot.
Matthew, can we hear you? Unmute yourself.
I think we're there.
Yay. We have achieved it. Are you going to be doing poetry or music?
Today, I just was going to listen in, trying to figure out what the difference between the regular song circle and the stone soup circle is.
I'll leave that to David to explain.
It's very esoteric.
David, are you unmuted? No.
Yes. Well, it's like this, you see. I like instrumental music, folk music, dance tunes and whatnot. I also like songs. And I also like all different genres of folk music, whether it's blues, whether it's bluegrass, whether it's old time music, whether it's British, Irish, Scottish, French, you know, Latin American.
Rock and roll.
Even. So in order to sort of, on the one hand, be self-serving and do something that I like to do, and on the other hand, counteract the sort of silo effect of all the different genres, you know, where the different musical tastes would congregate together and just do the same thing over and over. I had the idea to start a session where any type of traditional folk music would be in the mix, so to speak. Now, the Stone Soup reference has to do with the old folk tale about the poor soldier who was traveling through a village and no one would offer him anything to eat. And he told them that he knew how to make soup out of a stone and suggested at various times that in the process, while everyone was watching him, that various ingredients would make it even better. And everybody contributed a little something to the stone soup when it came out wonderful and everyone was fed. So that's why the stone soup session got its name. My cousin Ethan Young suggested it and I thought it worked well. So that's basically what the stone soup session is about. Whatever you have in the way of music, song, or poetry, you can contribute to the mix and we'll all be fed, as it were, in a spiritual sort of way.
Wonderful.
Well, so Matthew, do you have, you're just going to listen today, is that right?
Yes. I'm not the difference
between this and the Saturday session is that Stone Soup is longer, but Saturday is more frequent.
Okay.
And the poets show up everywhere, no matter what you do.
And the Celtic and the Celtic Sunday appears the first Sunday of the month.
And that one would seem to be self-explanatory.
It sort of is, except
to be, but you never know.
You never know.
What we say is,
I found myself my way to you guys by way of looking ahead. Tabbed for the song FOD and just had no idea, you know, had never heard of it, and found Terry's video.
I'm glad somebody,
which I think might be the only one out there on the internet.
It may well be. There may be a good reason.
Well, that by no way that would make yours the best one out there.
You're right.
Well, is that what happens to the food that turns into fodder?
I'm having heard the song, I'm still not really sure.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know what it is, so I guess we will run it on to the Harten Bunch. Let me mute this if I can figure out. I can't figure out how to do it now, Stuart, because I've unfortunately made this thing full screen and I cannot unfull screen it.
I will mute. Yeah, you need to make me the host because I can't do it.
Oh, I thought I had. Okay, just a minute. Let me get here. Oh, here's the deal. There's Stuart Moore. Make host. Yeah, there you go. That's good enough. Because okay. I'm going to be leaving here in a few minutes.
Okay, so I'm going to take over. Okay.
Yeah, okay, sure.
Mute all in 3, 2, 1. And Sandy, you're next. I'm going to butt out here.
Okay, well, we like to be the most diverse ingredients in the stone soup when we come. So the first time around, Jeff chose bok, which is pretty diverse from centuries ago. So I chose the exact opposite. I chose John Coltrane, who's a saxophonist. And what he considers one of his best compositions is a love ballad called Naima that he wrote for his first wife. And so to even make it more interesting, I figured out how to play it on a Native American flute, which has not been done before. And Jeff's going to play it on guitar, and we're going to do just the basic melody. What he's thinking, of course, it's all instrumental, about Naima is deep as the night, spirit of starlight, inspiration of great beauty, and love at first sight. So it's a love song. So our background has a heart back there. And then I'm going to, after we play the main melody, I'm going to play just a little solo that I wrote. And then it'll kind of end with the A you heard at the beginning. So this is Naima, written in 1959 by John Coltrane. Hold on, I'm sure this is good. Okay.
Quite familiar with that piece, and I'm amazed you guys did it.
Me too.
That was nice, Sandy.
Very impressive.
Yeah. Wow.
You don't get that at your usual folk joint. You know that.
No, not even your usual jazz joint.
How many joints you consume, you don't hear it.
Yeah. The Horton duo wins.
Yeah, we didn't have any joints, though.
It's not as good, but it was okay.
Yeah. You guys, see you guys later.
Okay, thanks, Rick. See you next time.
Bye.
All right. I will take over hosting duties.
Well, I caught you eventually.
That was fun.
But it sounded cool because it was all dissonant.
I'm going to mute everybody's, and then it's me. So there we go.
Yay.
1, 2, 3, mute all. All right. As we're still in the political season, I'm going to do one. I've lived in Austin long enough, or Texas long enough now, to remember when a certain musician ran for governor in this fine state just a few years ago. Kinky Friedman. And I was thinking of this song the other night. I was watching some old Opry show on TV from the 50s or 60s when I noticed instead of the nudie suits with all the rayon and the polyester and the fine stuff they have now, they literally had kind of cotton or whatever with sequins just stitched in, hundreds of thousands of sequins in these fancy suits. And there's one line in the song is, the sequins have all fallen from your clothes. So here it is, a song called Sold American. Faded, jaded, fallen cowboy star. Pawn shop stitching for your old guitar. Where you going? God only knows, the sequins have all fallen from your clothes. Once you heard the Opry crowd applaud, now you're hanging out at Fourth and Broad on the rain-whipped sidewalk, remembering the time when coffee with a friend was still a dime. And everything's been sold American. The early times is finished and the wonder's all red. Everyone's been sold American, been dreaming dreams in a roll-away bed, writing down your memoirs on a window in the frost, roulette eyes reflecting on another morning lost, hauled in by the metro for killing time and pain, with a singing brakeman screaming in your veins. And everyone's been sold American, the lonely night is mourning for the death it never dies. Everyone's been sold American, don't let me catch you laughing when the jukebox cries. You told me you were born so much lighter than life, but I've seen the faded pictures of your children and your wife. Now they're fumbling through your wallet, they're trying to find your name. It's almost like they've raised the price of fame. And everything's been sold American. No place to go and brother, no place to stay. Everyone's been sold American, just let that golden greyhound roll your soul away. Just let heaven's greyhound roll your soul away.
Very nice, Stuart.
Yay!
Did you say the author was?
Thank you.
That's Kinky Friedman.
Oh, Kinky Friedman. Yeah, that's right.
Kinky Friedman and the Texas Jew Boys. They also had a song, The Ballad of Charles Whitman, the shooter on the tower. So there was a rumor of a tumor. It's one of, anyway, he was nothing if not out there.
Yeah, so. He could turn a phrase. Is that right?
All right, moving right along now. We got Spirit Tom there. I'm going to mute everybody just a moment. One, two, three, mute all. Okay, Tom.
This is an ancient ballad from the November 15th, 2020. You may recall those days once upon a time. This morning at the Sunrise Homeless Memorial. We were told not to gather because of COVID, but all homeless are holy and visited by angels. The names of all missing on dog tags on the tree, all glinting and shining in the early morning wind. Emmy sang that anthem from 1993 as written and sung by Debbie D. And we talked as we shared this 27-year ceremony. Last year, 189 lost lives on Austin streets, now 254, now 256. Homeless keep dying. We bless their spirits as they leave us. She first began when invited to the veterans camp by the Mopac Tracks. Saw their despair post-Vietnam written in their eyes, got to know them. Life by life chose to remember them by calling out their names. For the official numbers of homeless in Austin are always undercounted. And those veterans were not the only ones counted out. And the names as recited past the last post-bugle call as remembered by every witness to these homeless as they fall, remembrance is all. Because if we are leaves falling from all autumnal trees, let us then be beautiful. Let us rise with the wind as it cracks us from branches and scatters us like seeds upon the grass. May we be mobile art galleries to delight the eyes of those who see our wrinkles as a sign of diversity. May we be mulched and composted eternally to return in new seeds and form a union of beauty, where combined in our singular universities, we may form carpets of tree canopies to shelter and shade all growing living species. Right now, just to be beauty is enough. Just reach out. Just touch. Thank you all.
Very nice, Tom.
Thank you, Tom.
Love it.
Thanks for reminding us. What's out there, man?
It's out there, baby. They're dead.
Camp Rat.
Yeah, Camp Rat. Wow, you knew that.
Absolutely.
Wow, that's really important. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, Tom, thank you. We're going to move to Mary Jane now. And I'm going to mute everybody in 3, 2, 1. Boom. Boom. There we go. Okay, Mary Jane, all yours.
Okay. Well, I was going to do In the Pines. And I think it's a traditional song, but it was recorded by Bill Monroe, the king of bluegrass, inventor of bluegrass. But this isn't exactly his version. It's close, but it's not. It's not necessarily the Bill Monroe version. Anyway, it does have a kazoo part, so I better get that ready. Okay. Treat me so. You've caused me to weep, you've caused me to mourn, you've caused me to leave my home. In the pines where the sun never shines, and we shiver when the cold winds blow. The longest train I ever saw went down that Georgia line. engine passed at 6 o'clock. The caboose went by at 9. In the pines where the sun never shines, and we shiver when the cold winds blow.
Mary Jane, yay!
You know that song. You know, I've heard versions that go back a long ways in either Appalachian country music or African American blues music.
Yes,
and I'm not really sure where it originated.
Yeah, the first one I remember hearing was called Black Girl, and so it was focusing on a little girl out in the woods, and I guess I didn't really want to do that one. and so when I found this one, I thought maybe this one was better just because it didn't get racial or anything about the song.
Well, Lead Belly recorded something like that in, I guess, the 30s. Yeah.
It was Where Did You Sleep Last Night, sometimes called Little Girl, sometimes called Black Gal.
Yeah.
And there was, and that was the Kurt Cobain, Nirvana, Lead Belly came up through that.
Genre. Yeah, it's not very flattering to the girl somehow, this particular version.
Well, cast it in old music, it's hard to find songs that are flattering to girls.
Well, yeah, it's kind of hard to find songs from the girl's point of view, even, you know, just so many of them. It's almost like for a while, I guess all the musicians in the world were men.
Wow.
I've been adapting songs for my purposes. This isn't one that I tried to adapt. You know, it's obviously written from the man's point of view, but it's kind of a different story. You know, it's like it almost sounds like he's been in jail or something. You know, he's been away for 7 long years and he seems to have some doubt as to whether his girlfriend would be waiting for him or not.
Female perspective songs.
Celtic music or Cajun music. I think there's a Cajun version. I forget the name of it. It's,
yeah, there it is. Happened. There is. Well, I forget who did that. Balfour's, I guess.
All right.
Yeah.
We're going to move on from this elucidating discussion on the feminine perspective in folk music. I moved to David Polacek, and I'm going to mute on one and a two and a three. David is over.
All right, then. So, Mary Jane, I can think of a lot of more or less feminist folk songs, starting out with Single Girl, Married Girl, for one thing. And many of them were brought to light by the Carter family. And the interesting thing about the Carter family is that, to a great extent, the musical performance aspect were actually two women, Sarah and Maybelle Carter, carried most of the musical load in that group. And they performed a lot of really interesting songs over the years. So this is one of theirs, and it's sort of surrealistic in a sense, because the lyrics are more of an impression than logical. And it's called My Dixie Darling. And Karen's going to give me a little help with the going to give a little help with the chorus here. Dixie darling, listen to this song I sing beneath the silver moon with the banjo right in tune. My heart is ever true, I love no one but you, my Dixie darling, my Dixie queen. Way down below the Mason-Dixon line, that's where the honeysuckles are entwined, that's where southern winds are blowing, that's where I long to be going. Girls up north in the gay finery, whirling around in a society, singing songs of Dixie darling, where I long to be. My Dixie darling, listen to this song I sing beneath the silver moon with the banjo right in tune. My heart is ever true, I love no one but you, my Dixie darling, my Dixie queen. See my gal in old Caroline, drink my booze, do as I please, for all those girls I long to squeeze. Singing songs of Dixie darling, that's where I long to be going, down where the jelly roll's growing with my Dixie queen. My Dixie darling, to this song I sing beneath the silver moon with the banjo right in tune.
From the man's point of view.
Very nice.
Sung by women.
Well, they didn't mind singing a song from the man's point of view. And I'll do it too. You know, I just kind of like it when I can find one that's either totally not from anybody's point of view or a woman's point of view.
Try
the butcher's boy. The butcher's boy is written from a woman's point of view. but it's a very depressing song because she kills herself, hangs herself in it, but she gives her feelings very well.
Self-destruction thing. I like the ones. See, there's a bunch of these murder ballads where the boyfriend kills the girlfriend, but there is another strain of song where the girlfriend turns the tables on the murderous boyfriend and murders the murderer preemptorily.
All right, I think this conversation is taking a wrong turn here, so I'm going to move along here to Birdman, who's smiling, so that should be good. I'm going to mute everybody. Here we go. Mute all. 1, 2, 3. Okay, Birdman, turn yourself on there.
Oh, okay. Mine was somewhere else. This one here is titled Existence. An empty vessel slips across the blank waves of tranquility, reflecting the surface of the harbor bound for serenity. Years ago, before man walked on the coastlines to explore the ocean, dinosaurs roamed where the ice has eaten away caves of history. Leaves float into the soft volcano ashes of the hills. If only the trees and leaves could talk. One path goes west along a little fence by all the buried skeletons. If only the animals, land or stones could talk, our ears would bleed. It's time to cherish the moments. As we explore life and all of its history, our hearts still have many burning questions. Thank you.
Very good. Wonderful.
Yeah, that got my mind off murder ballads and male chauvinism. So we thank you for that. And we're going to move right along here to Terry, who will make it us back in there. So.
Okay.
Or not. And I'm going to mute everybody on the count of a 1, a 2, a 3. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, I'm so impressed that Matthew would actually look up FOD and get the chords that I'll have to do it. So this song I got from a recording by Mike and Peggy Seeger. I'm not sure which album it was, but it was taken from the Lomax collections that their mother, Ruth Crawford Seeger, had transcribed. So it's a children's song, I guess. It's just a bizarre song is what it is. Well, I went down to the mowing field to rah, hoorah, follow Dinky Dino. I went down to the mowing field, fine. I went down to the mowing field. Big old snake come and bit me on the heel. Do-ra-dee-dee. I fell down upon the ground. Rah, do-rah, follow Dinky Dino. I fell down upon the ground, fine. I fell down on the ground and shut my eyes and looked all around. Rotty day. Stump or take my rest and rock and rock for the dead. On stump to take my rest, fine. Sat on stump to take my rest, up after woodchuck on his nest. Do roddy day. Well, woodchuck grinned a banjo song. Do rock to rock for the dead. Woodchuck grinned a banjo song, fine. Woodchuck ran the banjo song. Up come a skunk with his britches on. Do-ra-dee day. Woodchuck and skunk got into a fight. Do-rock, do-rock, follow dinky die. Woodchuck and skunk got into a fight. Fine. These verses are increasingly more difficult to pronounce, so I beg your indulgence. Run, Chuck and Skunk got into a fight. Smelled so bad that it put out the lights. Ooh, rotty days. Well, they danced and sang till the chimney began to rust. Did you catch that? They danced and they sang till the chimney began to rust. Okay. They danced and sang till the chimney began to rust. Do-rah, do-rah, fall and you die. They danced and sang till the chimney began to rust. Five. They danced and sang till the chimney began to rust. Hard to tell which smelled the worst. Do-rah-dee day. I think that's all the verses. Let me look it up real quick. I think that's all the song. That's about all you can stand, I guess. Took me a while to figure out they danced in the sun until they began to rust.
Very pleasant song.
Huh?
That was a fun song.
Someone was murdered.
Yeah. That was esoteric in a good way.
And it seems to be somehow related to a Jimmy Driftwood song called Rattlesnake Mountain, which is even sillier.
All right. Well, thank you for sharing that novelty item.
And with that, I have to say goodnight to everyone.
Okay. Anytime, Matthew, we're here. So
thank you.
Come on.
Great hearing all of you.
Thank you. All right. We're going to move on to Chip, and I'm going to mute everybody in 3, 2, 1.
There it is. All right. All right. Anyway, let's see. I was going to do something different because I thought it was the Celtic Jam again, but since I was mistaken, I'm going to change. Mary Jane mentioned Monroe, so I'll do another Monroe tune. But let me say first off, the worst hazard of playing in a group of people with a woman who changes the gender of the tune to a female version and you hear it multiple times over and over again, then when you sing it yourself without the female person and you sing the female version, you can get yourself rather embarrassed, which I've done many times. So anyway, let's see. So I'm going to do another short medley here. The first tune I may have done these two tunes before too here, but the first one is called Carroll County Blues. It's a Mississippi fiddle tune about Carroll County, or at least it was written in Carroll County, Mississippi. And the second tune is probably my favorite mandolin tune of all time that actually started life as a harmonica tune by DeFord Bailey, who was the first African-American to be on the Grand Ole Opry until Charlie Pride came along, and remains still only one of only three African-Americans who have been admitted to the Grand Ole Opry. And it's a DeFord Bailey tune called Evening Prayer Blues. And Bill Monroe kind of borrowed it from DeFord Bailey. And whenever he would play it, he would always credit DeFord Bailey with writing the tune. So here we go. Carroll County Blues followed by Evening Prayer Blues. Thank you.
Lovely, lovely, lovely.
That was
great. Really great.
Yeah, that's very relaxing. Very relaxing.
Thank you. Pretty. I heard the Monroe strum in the middle there a couple of times.
I had pretensions of playing the mandolin from time to time, but I never could get those wonderful tremolos.
Like, yeah, the tremolos.
You and Monroe do.
Yeah. All right. Very good. Very good. All right. Let's move along to Sandy and Jeff or Sandy. I'm going to mute everybody in 3, 2, 1, mute all. Okay, over to you.
Okay, well, since y'all liked that last John Coltrane, yesterday when I was trying to figure out the notes on these native flutes, I did another piece of his called After the Rain. And John Coltrane grew up in North Carolina. So a lot of this music y'all are playing is from North Carolina. And he was born way before my dad, back in 1926. So, and when he had his spiritual awakening, he started playing these, I think, very beautiful songs. So I'm going to do my arrangement of After the Rain on a bass flute here. Maybe, I don't know if y'all can see it here.
Beautiful.
Very pretty. Very pretty.
Nice, Sandy. I
like that bass flute.
Makes me mellow tone.
It sounds really good. I'm playing my bass D under it, and it's just gorgeous harmonies with that native flute. So maybe you can work up Love Supreme for next time.
Well, I was actually looking at Psalm and Exotica. I mean, I just printed out some notes, but I haven't actually tried to play them or even listened to them yet. But we'll see what. Well, I got a whole month before the next Stone Soup.
Okay,
cool. That's beautiful, beautiful. And I thank you for bringing that style and sensibility of the gorgeous jazz touch that John Coltrane had into this group. So,
thank you.
Thank you. All right, next, that would be me. So I'm going to mute everybody on the count of 3, 1, 2, 3. All right, This is a what sounds like a traditional English sea song. The best story I heard about it was that there was a fight in a pub in the north of England between two guys who were arguing about whether this song was written in the early 1800s or the late 1800s. It was written in 1964 by Ewan McCall, but sounds old. It's called The Shoals of Herring, the herring fish. With our nets and gear, we're faring on the wild and wasteful ocean. It's there on the deep that we harvest and reap our bread. As we hunt the bonny shores of herring, there was on a fine and a pleasant day, out of Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger, for to hunt the bonny shores of herring. The work was hard and the hours were long, and the treatment, sure it took some bearing. There was little kindness and the kicks were many, as we hunted for the shoals of herring. Oh, we left the home grounds in the month of June, and the canny shields we soon were bearing, with 100 cren of the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals of herring. Now you're up on deck, you're a fisherman, you can swear and show a manly bearing. Take your turn on watch with the other fellows while you're searching for the shoals of herring. Oh, we fished the sward and the broken bank, I was cook and I'd a quarter sharing, and I used to sleep standing on my feet, and I dream about the shoals of herring. Your net rope man now, boy, you're on the move, you're learning all about seafaring, that's your education, scraps of navigation, as you hunt the bonny shores of herring. In the stormy seas and the living gales, just to earn your daily bread, you're daring, from the Dover Straits to the Faroe Islands, and you're following the shores of herring. Oh, I earned my keep and I paid my way, and I earned the gear that I was wearing, sailed 10 million miles, caught 10 million fishes. We were sailing after shores of herring. Night and day, the sea we're daring. Come wind or come winter gale, sweating or cold, growing up, growing old or dying. Hunting for the shoals of herring.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. Yes, sir. Very good, very good.
Yeah, that was nice.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Okay. Now, moving right along, it's Tom. Tom is somewhere there in the Antipodes, in the Australasian mist, in the land of wonder down under. But if he's not here in 2 seconds, we'll come back. One, two, okay, we'll come back. And it's Mary Jane's turn, so I'm muting all. And a one, a three, and a two, and a one, mute all. All right, Mary Jane, all yours.
Thanks. Well, this song is a traditional song. It's called When Death Comes. And I only know it on the ukulele. So that's what I'm going to play it on. And I guess I'm going to get all my equipment together here. What you gonna do when death comes creeping in your room? What you gonna do when death comes creeping in your room? What you gonna do when death comes a creeping in your room?
Oh my Lord, oh my God,
Excellent.
Sister.
I don't know what I'd do if death came creeping in the room with a ukulele and a kazoo.
Well, I thought about it for Dia de los Muertos, but we didn't actually have one exactly on Dia de los Muertos. It got passed over.
Is that a linear ukulele or a reentrant stringing? Does it have a bass string or a high one?
This is a typical ukulele.
Reentrant. Stringing. Yeah, yeah.
I have a baritone with a low string, but it's all my other ones are, they all just have high strings. But I think it's good to have a low string for some songs.
Works for me.
But yeah. I usually just play the guitar on a song that requires a low string. Yeah.
I got to figure out two other strings if I move to a guitar, so, you know. So. I'm still a newbie, so. Anyway, it sounds like the great rhythm on that one, I think. Great hook, isn't it?
Well, thanks.
All right, Wim. It's Tom. Is Tom still with us?
I'm still here, baby.
Okay. I'm going to have Tom come on in now, and I'm going to mute everybody on the count of three. 3, 2, 1, mute all. Okay, Tom.
Okay. Now I'm okay. There's many stories, the lines in your face, things come out of the deep, they go back once they eat, they bite, chew, gorge and digest upon the crushed bones and flesh of innocence. They forget that hunger is forever, but innocence turns to experience after elections like this one. Ducks to geese with guns, but then while they humbly exist, that everything still exists. We, our parents, their ancestors, all stacked on different shelves. Labels say clearance, yet our uniqueness remains special, even when spoiled and stained. Someone always has to say something, sing something. Someone else always has to ignore us. So why do they say that they are homeless? It should be a temporary status like travelers. Every leaf is a universe connected to the world tree, as well as being singular in her diversity. Whatever tree gods or goddesses we ascribe to each, we have unique individuality. So when reading the names of the departed homeless this morning, I see several who were living poetry in Austin. Take David Sosquitz Colbert, poet of harmonica and tie-dye, whose life on Austin streets was profoundly troubling. You see, he was brave to an inordinate degree. He would carry signs and placards of intense profundity, which would confuse all the watchers of Austin. He would also come to open mics and play his harmonica and guitar between his words. He had a powerful effect on everyone who heard, but we would forget him. He would look me in the eye and question me like a tree interrogates all bulldozers. I welcomed him, but this was in the days of the hideout on Congress, and he and that venue have lost all leaves. It's autumn in Austin, approaching COVID winter. We were cool before we became cold to each other. We need the absurd surrealist spirit of David Sosquitz Colbert, musician and poet, before we all forget who we really, truly are. Just leaves blowing random harmonicas in the winds of chilling winter. Happy day.
Love it.
Thank you, Tom.
Very, I love very it.
Good. Good story, brother. Really nice poet, really good human being, dead.
Say his name again.
David Sosquitz Colbert. Sosquitz was the name that he gave himself, and David Colbert. You would have known he had a pot belly and crazy eyes, and he'd play his harmonic on the street. It was one of the true crazies of Austin.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Possessed by dubious spirits.
Yeah. All right. Very good. Well, thank you, Tom.
My pleasure.
Wait, okay, we're going all the way around to David again. I haven't missed anybody, and I'm pretty sure I haven't. I've got the list. Check it twice.
The Titanic had the list too.
Yeah. We've got more lifeboats. That's okay. I'm going to mute everybody.
Tom.
Yeah?
Doesn't the blood rush to your head?
No. You're all upside down.
It's a centrifugal force. Anyway, I'm going to mute everybody. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Boom. Oh, come on. All right. David, yours.
So here's a song from Britain. And Mary Jane, you can add this to your list of songs from a feminist perspective. It's called The Crafty Maid's Policy. Listen a while and I'll sing you a song of three merry gentlemen riding along. They met a fair maid, to her they did say, "We're afraid this cold morning will do you some harm." "Oh no, kind sir, you are vastly mistaken to think this cold morning will do me some harm. There's one thing I crave, it lies twixt your legs. If you'll give me that, it will keep me warm." "Well, since you do crave it, my dear, you shall have it, if you'll come with me to yonder green tree. And since you do crave it, my dear, you shall have it, I'll make these two gentlemen witness to be." And straightway he lighted, and straightway she mounted, and looking the gentleman hard in the face, said, "You knew not my meaning, you wrong understood me." And away she went galloping down the long lane. "Oh, gentlemen, lend me one of your horses, that I may ride after her down the long lane. If I overtake her, I warrant I'll make her return unto me my own horse again." But when this fair maid she saw him a-coming, she instantly then took her pistols in hand, saying, "Doubt not my skill, but you I would kill. I'll have you stand back, or you are a dead man. Oh, why do you spend your time here in talking? Oh, why do you spend your time here in vain? Come give her a guinea, it's what she deserves, and I warrant she'll give you your horse back again." "Oh no, kind sir, you are vastly mistaken. If it is his loss, then it is my gain. And you are a witness that he gave it to me." And away she went galloping over the plain.
A fine British equestrian ballad, that.
Yeah, I remember you did that song several weeks ago, and that's when my internet went out right in the middle of your song, and I never got to hear the end of it. So this was my first time. I've been wanting to hear the end of that song for a long time.
Okay, there you go.
What goes around comes around. See?
Kind of racy,
though,
isn't it?
All right, I'm going to move along here to Birdman and mute everybody in 3, 2, 1. Okay.
I'm on. This one here is titled "A Dreamer." While sleeping in the clouds and floating in the sky, just keep dreaming as life passes by. Thinking your dreams will keep you sane as you dream of happiness and life without pain. People will tell you that you're stuck in this place and that you won't go anywhere or win a race. In your dreams, you can say you're already there while floating around, going nowhere. Knowing someday you will have to wake up You feel like the world is more like a nightmare or a holdup. Feeling safe in a closed-eye wonderland. These words are for all the dreamers to understand. No matter what people may say, keep your dreams, but don't dream your life away. Thank you.
Good one.
Wise words.
Thank you.
That was very good. Yeah. Poetry that rhymes, man. God, what is that? All right, cool. That was, we're moving on now to Terry. I'm going to mute everybody. Three, two, one. There we go. All yours, Terry.
Trying to hit the little microphone with the mouse, you know, the thumb pick and the guitar and the harmonica. I'm getting in my way. But here we go. Now, I sang this yesterday. I hope it won't be too monotonous for those that heard it. But it's a nice song. I thought I'd do it again. Okay, get my lyrics up here. Okay, this is a song that was adapted by Jeff Muldar from a hymn that's normally sung in a New Orleans funeral. And he has a lovely guitar arrangement that I unembellished a little bit and added the harmonica. It's called Just a Little While to Stay Here. Soon the
this life will be all over, and our pilgrimage will end. Soon we'll take our heavenly journey and be home with friends again. Heaven's gates are standing open, waiting for our entrance there. Some sweet day we're going over, all the beauty is there to share.
Sweet. Like it.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Very nice, Terry. Very nice. All right. Yeah, to me, that goes with Tom's homeless list, that song. Would go very nicely.
Yeah.
All right, let's move on now. It's a Chip, and I'm gonna mute all. 3, 2, 1.
All right.
All right, who are yours?
Well, since this isn't an Irish session, and because I got all turned around and everything, let me do one that's not an Irish tune. Actually, the other song I did wasn't Irish. This is a song, this what made me think of this when we were talking earlier about the Carter family. They certainly did this song, and A.P. Carter was kind of known for early collection of tunes. One of the people that helped him collect tunes across their home region was a man named Arnold Schultz, who actually had a tremendous influence on Mother Maybelle's guitar playing style. And so there you have it. This is a song they did that also falls into the category of songs that I used to play with a female performer, and we sang it from the female perspective. So if I screw it up, it's just the way it is. It's this is Bury Me Beneath the Willow. So here we go. Is sad and I am lonely for the only one I love. When shall I see her? Oh, no, never till we meet in heaven above. Oh, bury me beneath the willow, under the weeping willow tree, so she will know where I am sleeping, and perhaps she'll weep for me. She told that she dearly loved me, how could I believe it untrue? Until an angel
softly whispered, she will prove untrue to you. Oh, bury me beneath the willow, under the weeping willow tree, so she will know where I am sleeping, and her half shall weep for me.
Family there.
A classic, you know, if you forget his name, you know, it had such an effect on Maybell's guitar playing. Maybell's guitar playing had a profound effect on every country guitarist that came after.
Absolutely.
The foundation of country guitar is playing.
Yeah, I mean, she didn't play as fancy as your Doc Watson or anything. But she set the style
and
the pace for all of them.
Yeah, I heard that A.P. Carter went around, got all these old tunes from church groups and camps and stuff, and changed one note and then copyright it for commercial gain. I don't know if that's true or not, but it's what I heard.
It's probably true. It's close to what I've heard.
It's way to build a business.
Well, the the irony is that he never claimed to be a folklorist, and yet it's his collection, as much as Lomax or Whitney Child, that is really preserved folk music. And
he was putting bread on the table. That's what he was doing. So. All right, that sounds great. Let's move on to Sandy. Sandy's next, and we're going to muting. Mm. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Boom. There we go. Okay.
Well, y'all kind of put me in the mood for some gypsy music. So this summer I learned how to play a gypsy scale. And so I wrote an original gypsy love song because I just wanted to write a pretty melody using the scale. And so I'm going to do it also on this bass flute here. Thank you.
Beautiful.
That was stirring. Yeah.
Play that scale for us.
Let's see if I can.
You max it all.
Okay, here's the scale. Those are my notes. I found this site on the internet that had a whole bunch of different scales. There's about like 8 different ones, like Byzantine, Japanese, you know, besides just your regular blues, major, minor. And so I just played through all of them. The ones I liked, I just started writing songs using that scale because it was just, they're just so unique. And I like that scale.
That has a North African, Middle Eastern, Sephardic music.
Yeah. Yeah. Somebody else said Romanian when I played this before. It just, it sounds Eastern European to me.
Yep.
Cool.
Hungarian. Yes.
Wow. Thank you for bringing that to the group. That's great. So.
All that gypsy music has strong Middle Eastern roots.
Yeah. It? Yeah. All right. That's me. Okay. Gonna mute everybody. It's tough being a manager and a player, man. Mute all. All right. This is one I've done periodically, but I really like it. It's a kind of mysterious song by Richard Thompson, and evidently it's his translation of a message given by a Iranian Sufi cleric in like the 1930s. It's called A Strange Affair. I've actually played this in a trio, playing the whistle part in Bilbao, Spain, and Vail, Colorado. In the distant past. This is a strange affair. The time has come to travel, but the road is filled with fear. This is a strange affair. My youth has all been wasted, and I'm bent and gray with years. Oh, my companions are taken away, and who will provide for me against my dying day? I took my own provision, but it fooled me and wasted away. This is a strange, this is a strange affair. Oh, where are my companions? My mother, father, lover, friend, and enemy. Oh, where are my companions? They're prisoners of death now and taken far from me. And where are the dreams I dreamed in the days of my youth? They took me to illusion when they promised me the truth. And what makes sleepers listen? Why do they need more proof? This is a strange, this is a strange affair. Won't you give me an answer? Why is your heart so hard toward the one who loves you best? When the man with the answer has wakened you and warned you and called you to the test. Wake up from your sleep that builds like clouds upon your eyes, and win back the life you had that's now a dream of lies. Turn your back on yourself, and if you follow, you'll win the lover's prize.
This is a strike. This is a strange affair.
Hey, Stuart. Yeah, good. Good one.
That could be done, I think, in a Middle Eastern scale.
I wish that.
if he'd have thought of it, if he'd worked on it longer, he'd have gone there. All right. Cool, let's move along. It's Tom. Back to Tom. Okay.
I'm with, right here.
With a three and a two and a one. Muto. Hey, Muto. Yay.
Forgive us for forgetting about the homeless. We're all doing what we can. Water, demonstrating against fracking, black people seeking not to be murdered, indigenous reminding us of their prior cultures, refugees still seeking shelter and sanctuary, indigo children aware and quite prescient, elders seeking security in retirement, California frontline global warning fires, Texas waters requiring care and curation, war is aware, is totally unacceptable as violence, freedom in the hands of all who can define and refine this, and you are part of all of this. Song people, art and chorus, accessories. We don't need to be great in what you do. You do not have to do what they say. You can get by while learning the true nature of work and play, how we have stars within us from deep space, never just Hollywood, and these points of light are in our eyes. Every time we admire, respect, elevate anything, everything in our purvey. Many dreams before us, after us, still more. But this dream, we're in this right now, this afternoon, is the right one to explore. We are each other's sanctuary. We meet when we can. We ask, where are they? Those whom we knew pre-COVID days. Most are too busy in their life. Goodness is in demand. Every now and then, a bird flips in to sing, I'm still here. I'm still here. Even if I'm separated from the circle, sing along. Cancer and COVID demand my attention. And that becomes our new anthem. We gather because we must. We gather because we can. Trespass upon the great silence and all the little silences, upon the breath that you're in right now and the one to follow us, upon innocence, experience, and all moments in between, upon the flower and the weed, bloom, decay, rebirth, life, death cycle in everybody, and here and now, in this space we cohabit and co-create peace, calmness, harmony, pleasure. Moments we treasure, asking for continuance, affiliation, extensions of cooperation. Are the homeless? We haven't forgotten them. Soon we will be them. Cheers.
Hey, Tom. Absolutely great.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Now and then.
Now and then, baby.
Just by the way, now and then. I loved it. I loved it. It didn't slip by me. I got it. Now and then.
Yeah. Happy is.
That was beautiful. All right, moving right along, we got Mary Jane, as we move into the last 30 minutes for the iron men and women who survived the third hour.
30 minute warning.
The end is nigh. All right, 3, 2, 1, boom.
Okay,
Mary Jane, sorry. There we go.
There. I'm going to do Shady Grove. Everybody knows it, but there are a lot of different versions, so maybe you haven't heard some of these verses I'm going to do. Shady Grove, my love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, bound for the Shady Grove. Peaches in the summertime, apples in the fall. If it weren't for my true love, I'd have no love at all. I wish I had a needle and thread, fine as I could sew. I'd sew my true love to my side, and down the road I'd go.
Shady Grove, my true love, Shady Grove I know. Shady Grove, my true love, bound for the Shady Grove. I wish I had a banjo string made of golden twine. I would play a song on it, hoping he'd be mine. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for the Shady Grove. Wish I had a pig in a pen, to feed him on, big strong man to stay at home and feed him when I'm gone. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I say. Shady Grove, my little love, don't wait for judgment day. Sunny on the mountaintop, shady in the holler. Everywhere my true love goes, I'd be sure to follow. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for the Shady Grove.
How many chords in that song?
Three.
Yeah. There you go.
Easy.
And the truth.
I played it with just two before, but I found a version with three, so I thought I could up my musicianship a bit.
I remember with two chords, so there you go.
Yeah, two chords is fine. It sounds just as good.
You have the sophisticated versions. All right. Cool. We're moving around. Probably one last time here. So David leads us off on the top of my list. So we will mute on the three and the two and the one. Boom. All right.
So Tom, with his poems, put me in mind of the this particular song I know, which is really about homelessness, and it's about the Gospels. Because if you read carefully what Jesus says, he was all about comforting the afflicted and afflicting the comfortable. And he emphasized the moral duty that Christians have of bringing comfort to those who are in need. So this song is all about that. And it's an old gospel song. Every version I've heard of it lacks a final chorus. So I wrote one to go along with it that I think fits. And it's called Tramp on the Street. Thank you. tramp was. Lazarus sat faint when he lay down at the rich man's gate. He begged for some crumbs from the rich man to eat. He was only a tramp found dead on the street, but he was some mother's darling, he was some mother's son. Once he was fair and once he was young, his mother she robbed him, her little darling, to sleep. But they left him to die like tramp on the street. Jesus, who died on Calvary's tree, shed his life's blood for you and for me. They pierced his side, Lord, his hands and his feet. Then they left him to die like a tramp on the street. He was Mary's own darling, he was God's chosen son. Once he was fair and once he was young, Mother Mary she robbed him, her little darling to sleep. But they left him to die like a tramp on the street. If Jesus should come and knock on your door for a place to come in or some bread from your store, would you welcome him in? Or would you turn him away so God would reward you on the great judgment day? We are all Mary's children, we are God's chosen ones, fair and not fair, young and not young. Loves all his children, and he wants us to keep his loved ones from dying like a tramp on the street.
Yeah, preach, preach, Brother David, preach.
It's Sunday, baby. It's Sunday. Sunday.
Somewhere.
Sunday.
Yeah, that's great.
Nice.
I want you to know that I'm cooking dinner, but I'm still listening. I don't think I've walked out on you.
That's good because you're up right after Birdman. Yeah,
I think I'm gonna pass on mine.
Okay.
I gotta cook dinner. But I'll stay attuned here.
Excellent.
Thank you. Okay, Birdman, we're gonna dial you in 3, 2, 1, boom, boom.
Okay, there we go. Yeah, this is a poem. I've read this in Austin before, and because we go to the casino where we used to, a lot of people thought that we had an addiction, but it's not just the casino we do. We do a lot of tours and stuff. This one here is called Casino Love. I actually read this at Stomping Grounds. Well, it used to be Stomping Grounds. It's no longer there. The mind is shuffling like a deck of cards as one card after another slowly covers another. A random memory falls together by the corners to deal from a pass at the bottom of the deck. Sadly, most will end up broke by playing two machines at a time. A casino lover wonders why he doesn't have a dime. Hitting the jackpot is the biggest dream, but odds are seriously low. You want to stop, but casino love is no joke. Either you will win or stay broke. Casino love is like a disease. You max your betting to win big. The addiction is so easy to attain with fun along with the thrill, but you won't win. You keep coming back when you know you should leave. Some lose their car, home, and even their family. When you win, you just keep playing, hoping, wishing, and waiting for the bonus to drop. You spend all your money because it is fun, but then you become addicted and are under the gun. It starts as a game that you play, but because a game that plays you, casino love is a disease that is insidious, if only you knew. Thank you.
Truer words were never spoke, my friend.
Yes.
Words were never spoke.
Oh, yes. We only spend like 3 days, 3 or 4 days there, but most of the time, like I said, we're doing tours. So, you know, we play on the slot machine, but we take a certain amount we're going to play. When we done, we done.
Well, if you consider it as entertainment and you're simply paying for the entertainment, it makes sense.
Yes.
If you think of it as something that's going to change your life for the better, nah.
All right. Yeah, you're right.
If it was about making people rich, the casinos wouldn't stay in business very long.
You're right about that.
That's the way they work it.
Yeah.
Good one. We've got to the messaging part of the afternoon. Let's see what happens with Sandy.
Yeah, preach it, Sandy. Preach it.
I'm going to mute everybody, so.
Good luck.
There we go. All right.
Okay, I'm going to do a poem this time because we're running out of time. And I do have a song called Mary's Song that I wrote, but that would go with David's song, but I don't want to have to find it. It would take too long. So I have a poem that I wrote called Magic Paintbrush. I am an artist. My paintbrush is a flute. My breath is the paint. Listen to my art. I delight in creating colors and expression deep within my soul of inner peace and transcendence. Sacred sounds give comfort, brushing through time. My spirit intertwines with soothing and dramatic melodies. My art reflects me and all humanity. Songs to the universe emerge from a magic flute.
And they do.
Yes, they do. That's beautiful.
Yeah. That was beautiful.
Yes. See, Sandy attempted to draw together the music and the words in one.
Music and muse, yeah. We are a
seamless message of nonverbal communication, or something like that. That was beautiful, huh? I'm going to ruin the mood now. This isn't a message, and it's very kind of commercial song, but I was struck by this song. It's a short country and western song, and I remember when Johnny Cash said he wrote to that Folsom City Blues, "I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die." He said that was the meanest, nastiest thing he could think of, so he put it into a song. To me, this song has a better line. It says, "If I thought my hand was against you, I'd cut off my arm and I'd walk off and leave it behind." And I thought, you can't get more badass than that. So anyway, I'm going to mute everybody and we'll get into that song. All right, this is a song, it's called "I Must Have Done Something Bad." It's written by Red Lane, and George Jones sang it, and Merle Haggard sang it. And it's a very guy, it's a very male song. I'm sorry, Mary Jane. This is the antithesis of anything decent or female. So, and he's whining because his female, left him anyway. I must have done something bad sometime in my life, and I paid for it time and again. But this time you hurt me so bad I could lay down and die, and the pain grows each day 10 times 10 times 10. If I thought my hand was against you, I'd cut off my arm, and I'd walk off and leave it behind. And if I thought that you needed money, then I'd sell my own soul, and I'd even steal from the poor and the blind. How about that then? I can't understand how eyes can glitter like fire. Why, you had me fooled all along. I gave you all that I had, and I searched round for more, and now I've got nothing at all, and you're gone. I must have done something bad sometime in my life, and I paid for it time and again, and again.
Your brother sing it.
That was good.
Time and time again.
All right. Enough tears and the beers on that one. We go to Tom.
I'm ready, Bill.
And then Mary Jane, and then David will take us to the Hallelujah wind up at 5 o'clock. So.
Okay.
So Tom's next. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Mary said, no matter what you call your sessions, the poets will turn up anyway. So it's a love poem and why we turn up. You have loved her as she was, and she has loved you all back. Perhaps you loved her waters that sprang and gushed once high. Poet Susan Bright praised those trees who loved those waters alchemically. Perhaps you had family here, or you played in multiple bands. Charles Perrone had both when he was in her hands. Maybe it was her hidden hearts, the core of which was sung by Albert Hofstickler, poet of the Hyde Park bench. Or maybe the shift from Yang to Cosmic Cowboy, from barroom to bookstore and coffee shop. Chuck Taylor can spin you yarns of days of Austin past, as we all can, tied to all her changes. While we loved, she left. Musicians in closed down venues. Librarians ditto, and every fab coffee shop devotee who loved her only as poetry must find new names to sing her praises. We own nothing but our memories, all distinct as black and white photographs. Austin, now the Waterloo of all our dreams, desires, aspirations of every person who has come and gone on the stages of Buddha, Carl, Round Rock, Georgetown, San Marcos. She has left us with each other this afternoon. And we still have no time, but many more stories to discover and uncover in the gloom. Happy days. And that's why we're music venture.
Yes, Tom.
Thank you, Tom. That was great.
Very good.
Spot on, as usual. Or on the spot. Yeah, yeah. One of those. Or both.
Jump, spot, jump.
Yeah, sometimes I'll read the Les Barker story about Spot of the Antarctic, but not today. So this Mary Jane, and then David will do the final song. So muting all. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. All right, Mary Jane, there you go.
Okay. Well, I'm going to do the Salty Dog Blues. So, it's supposed to be a traditional song. It certainly sounds like one. I'd be surprised to learn otherwise. Standing on the corner with the lowdown blues, great big hole in the bottom of my shoes. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog. I won't be your man at all. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Listen here, Sal, well, I know you run down stocking in a worn out shoe. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog. I won't be your man at all. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Down in the wildwood, sitting on a log, finger on the trigger and an eye on the hog. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog. I won't be your man at all. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Trigger and they said go. Shot fell down in Mexico. Honey, let me be your salty dog. Let me be your salty dog. I won't be your man at all. Honey, let me be your salty dog.
Yay, Mary, yay. Love it.
Great. Very timely. Now, all that's left is for David to sing the parting glass and a tune on the whistle, and we're out here. Just want to say thanks to all the poets and the singers and the empty chairs. It's all good. And see you all next time. So, David, take it away. We're going to mute everybody. Three, two, one. Boom.
Thanks, Stuart.
Thank you.
So the parting glass and then that jig that's called Happy to Meet and Sorry to Part. Spent it in good company, and all the harm that I ever did, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy be with you all. Oh, if I had money enough to spend and leisure time to sit a while, there is a fair maid in this town who sorely has my heart beguiled. Her rosy cheek and ruby lip, I own she has my heart in thrall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy be with you all. Oh, all the comrades I ever had, they're sorry for my going away. And all the sweethearts I ever knew, they'd wish me one more day to stay. But since it falls unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call, good night and joy be with you all. I'll softly rise and I'll gently call, good night and joy be with you all. Bye, everybody. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Could someone send those words and that music in email so we could learn the words and song?
Sure. The parting glass. You got it.
Yeah, the parting glass.
Put the last verse in the middle, though.
So okay. That'd be great.
Thank you. Thanks.
I'll send it to Terry and he can distribute it.
To everybody. Yeah, that'd be great.
All right.
Thank you, Stuart.
Peace, everybody.
Bonsoir.
Thank you, Birdman.
Bon nuit.
Thanksgiving, baby.
Dos vidania. Here we go. I've got the power. Here it goes. Hey. Oh.